Welcome back to the final stage in the final area of this dark vision, Dark Cochreal. So, I have to say that Dark Cochreal is a lot easier than Dark Anima last time, because we need to deal with his gimmick. On the Dark Vision 10, we need to deal with Elemental Resistance, do a dispelling and recast Elemental Resistance multiple times. But this time is completely different. Dark Cochreal had a 96% mitigation up for 5 turns, and you need to deal damage and drop his HP to below 50% in 5 turns. If you are unable to do that, at the end of turn 5, he will cast an unresistible death to your team. Which means that the first half of this fight, you need to drop his HP to below 50%. And the second half that you need to do some setup and burst him down and make sure damage above 2.14 billion and you get a maximum score. Okay, let's start with the first unit. For Mastermind Sword, you don't need to build him for a physical evasion and provoke tank like this. The point to build him is you need to have as much limit fail and limit fail each turn as possible. Because we need to fulfill his limit gauge on turn 1. Call of the Wild is the most important here. The point of turn 1 LB fail is because we need dual stack mirror. For Fang, he surprised me so much. Her damage is very, very high. To build her, you need to have 2 spears. That is the most important on her, because she can take full benefit from Spear Imperial. So give her 2 spears. If you don't have STMR spear, you can give her 2 Crimson, but this spear is from Robota TM. It gives you a Dragon Killer and Jump Damage. And on her ability slot, give her Dragon Killer as much as possible. With this build, she has an 800% Jump Damage, 250% Dragon Killer. King Edgar gonna be a breaker in the first 5 turns. On his normal form, give him a Burma Call for a 10% fire amplifier. He don't need any gear here, but if you want some safety, you can give him a LB field equipment. On his brave form, gear him as usual. Jump Damage and Dragon Killer. Don't forget you need 2 Spear, so he can take a full benefit from Spear Imperial. With this build, he has 300% Dragon Killer and 800% Jump Damage boost. Infernal Rain gonna be an LB Chainer and Summon Irith for Irith Field. On his normal form, I give him only 4 Behemoth Synergy. This gonna be guarantee that I able to summon effect on turn 2. On his brave form, gear him Light Terra. His magic, evoke damage, evoke magic, and limit burst damage. He quite hard to gear because it feel like he has 0% on magic, so you need to give him magic. For Terra, she had allowed 200% magic, it's quite easier to gear. And don't worry that much, we're not gonna expect that much on his damage. So my limit burst is only level 1. For Terra, she will be everything in this fight. It's quite like she will be a support. That if you're unable to do this, she will do it for you. Okay, on her normal form, I give her Lion Emblem. So this accessory can provide Fire Remix Crystal. Okay, it's better than nothing. Not only that, I give her 10,000 needles. If my mastermind thought unable to cast Mira, she able to do that for us. And her brave form, gear her as usual. Evoke magic, evoke damage, and limit burst damage. Last Malekan will be another LB finisher. Not only that, he will provide us a dragon killer. For his normal form, give him limit fill each turn and limit fill rate boost. On his brave form, give him a dragon killer, limit burst damage and attack. One thing I need to mention here is he able to equip spear. If you have Duke STMR, it's very good to give him Duke STMR so he can take some benefits from Spear Imperil. He has 300% Dragon Killer and 300% Limit Burst Damage. Okay, that's all for the team. Let's go. Alright, turn 1 is the hardest turn. If you can pass turn 1, the rest are easier. Okay, the key of turn 1 is you need to fulfill Mastermind Zorn LB. Let's start with Edgar. Use Dignify King of Figaro, Bravo Figaro, and let's Miracle Blaster. For this setup, we're gonna fulfill his limit gauge and break board with 84%. And Fang use Gastel mode and Geo Paradise for fill her LB. Last Will Legend, Triple Cat Gleaming Azure Blade. Infernal and dual cast his cooldown and let do a blade saber for fire imbue. Hopefully it generates crystal enough for mastermind song. Okay, that's not enough, but don't worry. On Terra, use rallying cry to fill LB. And the clock is triggering on mastermind song for dual stat mirror. Mastermind Zorn LB has dual stat mirror, you don't need to cast mirror on turn 2. So on turn 2, we're gonna copy everything. Okay, for turn 2, let's start with Last Will Legend. Use Complete Awakening, Dragon Slayer Blade, and let's use Gleaming Azure Blade to fill LB. For Infernal Lane, let's shift to his Breath form, so we're gonna summon Ifrit for a 5 physical attack field. Terra shift to her Breath form, so we start set up this turn. Let's use Magitek Power, release Fire and Transburst. For Edgar, let's shift to his Breath form and use Limit Burst for a better Spear Imperil. Because we used a Fang cooldown last turn, so we need to do a jump this turn. Before that, let me copy everything. So Mastermind Zorn will use Critical on Last Will Legend, Elemental on Infernal Fire Lane, and Project to everyone. Alright, on turn 3. Okay. Calm down. This turn, you need to do everything in order. We're gonna burst down first, and after everybody on the field, we're gonna use the clock ticking again. So, Infernal Rain and Terra use their limit burst. Last Will Legend shift to their bear form and use a Azure Flaming Ice Blade. For somebody who don't know, Infernal Fire Lane LB is equal to Triple Cat Absolute Mirror of Equity Chaining Mode. Okay, let's send Terra first. After that, for second, send Absolute Mirror of Equity Chain. And then when you see 300% on screen, drop Fang down. Alright, everybody is on the field now. Use Mastermind Zorn first. For Mastermind Zorn, use the clock is ticking. So everybody on the field will have a dual stat mirror again. After that, jump Edgar up. Okay, that's all for this turn. Alright, on turn 4, we're gonna do a chaining and burst style again because Edgar is still on the air and he's gonna landing next turn. So let me start with Infernal Fire Rain. So let's triple cast Fire Beast Howl, Fire Beast Sword Stand, and Blade of Grand Shell. For Fang, if your Fang limit is not fulfilled, you can use Geoparadise 3 times to fulfill her limit gauge. We need her limit gauge to power up her jumping ability. Terra, Legan, and Sorn don't have anything to do this turn, so we can guard all of them. Okay, on turn 5, this gonna be a final turn that he had a 96% mitigation. If you unable to drop his SP below 50% in this turn, he will kill your team. Let's start with Fang. So we're gonna set up her burst first. So this setup is for the final turn kill. So let's use Dragon Volley. Infernal Rain gonna chain with Last Will Legend, so use his limit burst. Last Will Legend triple cast Azure Flaming Ice Blade. And let's chain first. Yes, we're gonna chain first. Okay, chain first. After you see 300% on the screen, drop Edgar. Beautiful. It's below 50% now, so you pass the first stage. Let me say something about Terra. She had a free turn here with Mastermind Sword. If your Edgar limit is not fulfilled, you can use Rallying Cry from Terra to fulfill his limit gauge. We also need his limit gauge too because we need to set up the second burst. Alright, for turn 6, this turn we have a free turn. We're gonna use this turn to do a 100 chain score. So let's triple cast everyone. For Edgar and Infernal Rain, let's triple cast that Stardust Ray chaining move. Mastermind Sword and Last Will Legend triple cast their Absolute Mirror of Equity chaining move. Don't forget to shift back because we're gonna do a setup and we need to shift back to Brave Form again to do a burst damage. And Terra, let's use Rallying Cry. And that is 100 chain score. Alright, turn 7. Edgar and Fang use their limit burst. So their limit burst gonna boost their jumping ability. Infernal Rain gonna do let me do something on him. So let's cast his cooldown and fire imbue. Mastermind Sword gonna copy that, so use Elemental on Infernal Rain. We're not gonna set up anything here because most of the setup has a pre-turn effect key. Let's guard Terra and Last Will Legend. Alright, on turn 8, let's use Jump ability, so we start with King Edgar, use Figaro Jump. For Fang, let's use Gastal Mode. Only, yes. Because we need to change High Wind to High Wind Plus. That's all what we need. And for Infernal Fire Rain, let's shift to his Brave Form, so we're gonna summon Ifrit again for 5 physical field. Last Will Legend, just use his Father Sun Bond and... No. Let me fill his limit gauge first. So use Father Sunborn and Gleaming Azure Blade. Terra help fill Last Will Legend limit gauge with a Rallying Cry. And for Mastermind Sword, he don't have anything to do, so let Elemental on Rain again. Okay. For turn 9, this gonna be a setup for Burst next turn. Let's start with Infernal Rain. So we're gonna use 5 Beast Hound, 5 Beast Sword, Stand and Blade of Clan Shells. Terra shift to her Blade form and use Magitek Power Release Fire and Transburst. Let me say something, Cochlear is very fragile here, so you can kill it very easy, so beware about that. And for Fang, let's use her jump ability, High Wind Plus. Laswell Legend, let's do a full setup here, so Triple Cast, Complete Awakening, Dragon Slayer Blade, and Ignite Twin Blade. Metamyson now able to dual cast only, so we're gonna copy killer only, so let's critical on last Will Legend and project to everyone. And as you can see here, the damage from last Will Legend does 20% of his HP. Alright, on the kill turn, last Will Legend, Terra and Infernal Rain use their limit burst. Mastermind Triple Cat Absolute Mirror of Equity Chaining Book. For the order, we're gonna send Terra first. 4 seconds after that, send AMOE Chain. And after you see 300% on screen, send Jumper and Last Will Legend. Okay? Let's start with Terra. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, if you able to do a perfect chain, you need to have a 53 chaining on the screen. Okay, that is the cap damage with maximum score on this Dark Vision. Hopefully this video able to help you or give you idea to do a fight in this stage. Okay, thanks for watching and bye.